Well, we're going to go to the word of the Lord on tonight. We're going to look at Exodus, the 12th chapter, beginning at the 12th verse, Exodus 12 and 12 and verse 13. We'll commence reading at verse 12 and verse 13, Exodus 12, 12 and 13. Sheldonia, that's my wife. Can you be my scribe tonight and just make sure to type in the lesson, the scriptures and the points as well? I appreciate you all. Hey, everybody can be a scribe tonight. All right. If something blesses you, just type back and let me know that you enjoying the word of the Lord. Exodus 12 chapter, beginning at the 12th verse and the 13th verse. It reads as thus, "For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night and will smite all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast. And against all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgment. I am the Lord. And the blood shall be to you for a token or a sign upon the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over. And the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt." Wow, that's so powerful on tonight. Exodus 12 chapter is a story that deals with Moses and how he is given strict instructions as to how to handle the plagues that have come into the land of Egypt. We all know that there were 10 plagues that hit the land of Egypt. If I had my son here, he could run down and give you all the plagues. I don't have time to give you all the plagues. There were flies, there were locusts, there was water turning into blood, there was darkness, there were the water turning into blood, talons, hail coming down, so much. And look at the Bible, lets us know that he says, "I'm going to prevail over all the gods of Egypt." And each one of the plagues that hit Egypt, it attacked a god that they worship. Isn't that something? All right. They worship the Nile River. So he calls the waters to turn into blood. And that's a praise right there, because the Lord is letting us know that we have the upper hand, that if God be for us, who can be against us? There is no God like our God. And there is no God in Egypt or in any other God that can defeat our God. And so the Bible lets us know that Moses is given strict instructions as he's supposed to protect the children of Israel. And the Bible says he's told to kill a lamb and to take the blood that is from the lamb and place it upon the doorpost. Look at this now. And the Bible says he tells him that "I'm going to pass through the land of Egypt this night." I come to tell you that God says tonight, "I'm going to work a wonder. Tonight, I'm going to do something that may have taken many people years to accomplish. But in one night, everything that had you bound," the Holy Ghost says, "it has to let you go." I come to give God a praise, because I want you to know that this is your day to declare your emancipation from the hand of the enemy. God has given you the victory. I need somebody to give me a heart attack right now. Tap those hearts. And you that are on the conference call, I want you to shout amen. You're on mute, but you can still shout amen. Hallelujah. Tonight is your night. You're coming out with all that God has for you. And the Bible says, "I will smite the firstborn in the land of Egypt." The firstborn represent inheritance, all right? It represents inheritance. The firstborn represents the inheritance. Praise the Lord. And I want to let you know that God says, in this season, "I'm going to preserve your inheritance," all right? An inheritance is given to someone after the one that has the inheritance dies, all right? The parent, they pass it on to the son, all right? Or they pass it on to the one that is legally entrusted to receive the promise. And so he says, "I'm going to give you, amen, your inheritance back." Praise the Lord. What's your inheritance? Praise the Lord. Everything that's owed you. Praise the Lord. Everything that was stolen from you, God says, "I'm going to give it back to you." And he also says to him, "I'm going to smite the firstborn in the land of Egypt." Look what he says, "both man and beast." Not only just a human, but I'm going to attack the livestock, all right? Now, why did he attack the livestock? Because the Lord is saying, in this season, I've got to remove perverted worship and perverted sacrifice. We're in a day and a time now where God, praise the Lord, is calling for true worshipers to worship Him how? In spirit and in truth. But unfortunately, people have been offering up sacrifices that God has turned down. They've been offering up sacrifices not unto God, but they've been offering up sacrifices, praise the Lord, for mammon, for gain, all right, for selfish gain. They have forgotten about God. And I believe in this time of quarantine, God is trying to bring us back, hallelujah, to the most important thing. First things first, He says to us to love the Lord thy God with all your heart, your soul, and your might. Praise the Lord. So God says, I'm getting ready to give you your passion and your love for me back. Praise the Lord. But He says, I'm going to cause you to come to a place of renewed sacrifice. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. We've been given to so many other things. We've been given to the creditors, and now a lot of us don't have no money at this time, unfortunately, to give to the creditors. Praise the Lord. But God says, I want you now to give me your time, your talent, and your tenth back to the Lord. Praise the Lord. And then He says to us, I'm going to do this against all the gods of Egypt. I will execute judgment. And then He says this, I am the Lord. Praise the Lord. He says, I am the Lord, which lets us know that He reiterates who He is. He says, I am the Lord. I am the ruler. I am the provider. I am the great God. I am not just a God, but I am the God. I'm the only one. No one beside me. No one before me. No one can take my place. There may be other lowercase g's. He said, but I'm the big G. Come on, somebody. I'm the big G. I'm not negating that there aren't other gods, but He said, I am the big G. In other words, I got power over the little gods. And then the Bible says, and the blood shall be to you as a token upon the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you. Now, many times we have said that the death angel came and passed over, amen, the houses. But we see the scriptures that say it was a death angel, but it was God Himself that was going to do this. That's a praise right there. The Lord says, I'm going to do this. Glory to God. I don't need no help. I don't need no assistance. God says, when I deliver you, He said, I'm coming down myself and I'm going to release you. Because many times if men come in to release you, they may only release the people that they like. Come on, somebody. But God says, when I do it, I'm not going to do, my dad says, a half-done job. He said, but when I come to deliver, He said, I'm going to deliver everything that concerns you. That's a praise right there. I wish somebody could give me a heart attack right now. I wish somebody could holler back at your boy, because God says, I'm getting ready to deliver everything in your house. Praise the Lord. Your family is going to be delivered. Your children going to be delivered. Hallelujah. Your sons and daughters going to be delivered. Can somebody say praise Him? Hallelujah. Glory to God. And then He says, when I smite the land of Egypt. Pray, go, glory to God. When I smite the land of Egypt, He said, the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you. It's not going to come. Psalms 91 and 10. I feel good right now. Psalms 91 and 10 and verse 11 says this. He gives us another promise. He says, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. We have another promise from God. And that promise is no evil shall come upon thee. Who am I talking to in here? He wants me to let you know that the weapon will form. The enemy will snarl and show his teeth. And he may lick his lips at you and say, I'm going to eat pork chops tonight. But the Holy Ghost says that no evil shall befall thee. I need somebody to give God just a little bit of praise. If you believe, hallelujah, that the enemy may come, but he will not get an advantage over you. Because God says you're covered in the blood. I need somebody right now, hallelujah, to give God just a little bit of praise, because you're covered in the blood. And the Bible says, neither shall any plague. He says evil won't come. That means the enemy won't come. The enemy will not come to destroy you. Praise the Lord. He will come, but he will not prosper. It will form. It will not prosper. He will come, but he will not advance. And then he says, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. That's why I almost lost it. He even told me to tell you that the plague, the COVID-19, won't even come near your address. Who am I talking to in here? Hallelujah. How glory to God. Your mask ain't going to protect you. The gloves are not going to protect you. But I need somebody to give God just a little bit of praise, because the Lord says you're covered in the blood, and the plague may go down the street. Praise the Lord. It may hit next door, but the Lord, matter of fact, I need to rephrase that. It won't even come near you. I need somebody to praise God, because your whole block is going to be delivered because you on the block. Come on, somebody. I need to praise here, because you on the block. Nobody on your block, nobody on your street is going to feel the effects of the virus. It's not even going to come near you. Glory to God. If you on that street, just know that whole street is covered in the blood. I want you to understand that from Genesis to Revelation, we see that God has always showed us that he had a plan of redemption for the people of God. It was through his blood. Amen. We see that with Abel, praise the Lord, he offers up a sacrifice, hallelujah, of the firstlings, hallelujah, and how God, amen, accepted it by sending down fire. As legend has it, the fire came and consumed that our sacrifice, and Cain got upset and killed him. We also see that Noah, praise the Lord, when the Lord brought him out, hallelujah, of the 40 days and 40 nights of the flood, the Bible says that he offered up a sacrifice unto the Lord. Praise the Lord. So we see that sacrifice. Isaac, he offered up a sacrifice unto the Lord. Hallelujah. So we see we're going into April, and the month of April, the 12th, we understand that's Passover weekend. And I believe as we go into Passover weekend, hallelujah, that's a praise for us right there, because we see that blood is necessary, hallelujah, to cause the judgment of God to pass over us. Praise the Lord. The judgment says that he's going to make a ruling or a verdict, hallelujah, that may not be in your favor. That means you've done wrong. And so now he bangs the gavel and says, I'm getting ready to sentence you. But I'm glad to know that the blood does something very unique. The blood gives every believer a favorable judgment. I need somebody to put that in on the screen, that the judgment is in your favor. God told me to tell you, hallelujah, you that are on this live, praise the Lord, Lord, you that are on this conference call, he told me to tell you that the judgment is going to be in your favor. Yes, you have evidence. Yeah, you have facts. And Jesus says, I'm your lawyer and I'm going to get you the winnings. Come on. Hallelujah. That is owed to you, says the Spirit of the Lord. I'm going to give you four things, praise the Lord, that the blood does. I'm going to give you four things that the blood does. Number one, God promises through his blood to rescue us. In Exodus 6:6, he says, I will bring you out from under the yoke of the Egyptians, to be up under the yoke or up under the bondage, to be up under the control or the manipulation. God says this year, I'm going to break off the manipulation, hallelujah, of people and the control and the witchcraft of people that have held you hostage. Come on, that have held you out, hallelujah, of what God has promised you. But he told me to tell you, I'm going to bring you up and out from up under the yoke of the enemy. Who am I talking to in here that can give God just a little bit of praise? Hallelujah. Because he's going to bring you up and out of the yoke of the enemy. So number one, God promises to rescue us. Hallelujah. He promises to deliver. He promised that we're going to make a great escape. Look at this. In one night, I come to tell somebody, God's going to make you an overnight wonder. In one night, God's going to move you from a prisoner to a prince. I need a dance right there. I need a heart attack. I need somebody to holler on the conference call, because I believe he's going to move you from the prison, from being a prisoner to a prince. Glory to God. From a prisoner to a princess, from a prisoner to a king, from a prisoner to a queen. Can somebody give God praise? Hallelujah. He says, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. You've been rescued from sin. You've been rescued from bondage. Number two, God promises to release us. Glory to God. I don't know about you, but I feel a mighty release in the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. He says in Exodus 6:6, he said, I will free you from being slaves to them. Glory to God. Not only am I going to rescue you, bring you out from under the yoke, he said, but number two, I'm going to free you from being slaves to them or to the Egyptian. How many know that at one time we all were bound by sin? We all were enslaved by the enemy. But Jesus, his mighty precious blood, he redeemed us from the curse of the law. He redeemed us and he brought us up under the control and the manipulation of the enemy. Glory to God. I want you to understand that number two, he says, I'm going to release you. I need somebody to put in the screen, everything's been released. Glory to God. Matter of fact, I need you to say everything the devil held up has been released right now. Who am I talking to in here that believes everything that the enemy has locked up? The Holy Ghost says, I've released it tonight. Woo, Shama. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Lord, I'm getting excited. Let me calm down. He says, I've released you. The handcuffs are coming off. The shackles are coming off. Everything that the enemy has held up, the Holy Ghost says today it's been released. Number three, he promises to redeem us. Number three, he promises to redeem us. To redeem means to pay a ransom for something to its original owner. All right. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. In other words, there was a debt that was owed that nobody was able to pay. We didn't have enough money to pay it. But Jesus, glory to God, through his precious blood, he redeemed us. He brought us back. Come on, somebody, to our original owner. Glory to God. He redeemed us. You have redeemed us. The Bible says in Exodus 6, it says he has redeemed us with an outstretched arm and mighty acts of judgment. Glory to God. Who am I talking to in here that knows that everything was against you? But Jesus, he reached way down and he picked you up and he rescued you out of a horrible pit. As my dad, Bishop Hyman, would say, who wouldn't serve a God like this? So he redeems us. And when he redeems us, he adopts us and gives us the right to be called the sons of God. Glory to God. He gives us our privilege back. He gives us our rights back. When you were up under the bondage of the enemy, you had no rights. Glory to God. You had no bill of rights. You had no constitution. You were a slave. And when they told you to work, you had to work. They told you when to sleep. They told you when to get up. But when God has set you free, you're no longer bound by the enemy. You are free. Come on, somebody. Not free to do what you want to do. You can do what you want to do. But the Bible said in Romans 6, shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? The Bible says, God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? We're not free to sin, but he says we're free from sin. Glory to God. And now he says you have been redeemed, and now you can call me Abba Father. He says you're no longer a slave. He said, but now you can call me Papa. I need somebody to begin to declare I'm free. Glory to God. Come on, type that in the chat. Come on, type, I'm free. He who the Son has set free is free indeed. Come on, type. Type it. Come on, say it right now. I'm free. I'm free. Glory to God. Number four, very powerful promise. Our last promise. Number four is that God promises to restore us. Glory to God. Glory to God. He promises to restore us. He said in Exodus 6:7, he said, I will take you as my people and I will be your God. That's Exodus 6:7. Glory to God. He also said in Jeremiah 31:33, he says in Jeremiah 31:33, he says, this is the covenant I will make with the house of Israel after that time, declares the Lord. I will put my law in their minds. and write it in their hearts or on their hearts. I will be their God and they will be my people. Look at this. For I will forgive their wickedness and remember their sins no more. I want you to know that anytime something is restored, it is brought back to its original glory or its original design or intent. When Adam messed up in Genesis, the third chapter, he lost his position. He lost his authority. He lost his rights. Hallelujah. But when Jesus shed his precious blood, he restored everything that the enemy had taken from him. I feel a praise right now. I need somebody to type in the chat, everything restored. Good God Almighty, who am I talking to in here that can give God just a little bit of praise? Because the Lord told me to tell you, everything's restored. Glory to God. Come on, type in the chat, say everything restored. Everything restored. Your marriage is being restored. Your family is being restored. Your finances are being restored. Your health is being restored. Everything. I don't know who I'm talking to, but there's someone that may be sick on tonight. You may be going through something, but the Holy Ghost said, if you can just type everything restored, God said, I'm going to touch you. That we're dealing with social distancing. We can't touch everybody. How, that's what they say. But I believe as you type in the chat, everything restored, God's going to touch you. He's going to touch you from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. Can somebody give God praise just a little bit? Glory to God. Because he says everything is going to be restored. Glory to God. Your money, come on, not just stuff, but your relationship with God is being restored. Yeah, we've been quarantined. Glory to God. We've been locked in, but we have not been locked out. God has locked us into a place, but hallelujah, but he has not locked us out, for the promises of God are yea and amen. And I want you to know that everything that God says you can do, he said you can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. No restrictions. Hallelujah. No longer will you be held back or held up. But God says, I'm going to give you the power to break through. Who am I talking to in here that has seen some things, that has tried to keep you? You can see your way out. You can see your life doing better. But there's something in your mind that's telling you that you can't make it. But I need somebody right now to begin to declare no restrictions. Come on. I've been set free. I've been rescued. I've been released. I've been redeemed. And I've been restored. Woo, good. God Almighty. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I just thank God for this opportunity just to share the word of the Lord with you. I want you to understand that the title of this lesson, I forgot to give you my message on today. If you see it in the chat or in the title, but the message for today is home security. I want you to declare on this chat, I have home security. That's a praise right there, because the enemy has tried. He's been trying to break into your home. He's been trying to sneak in through the back door. He's been trying to pick the lock. He's been trying to tamper with your home security. But the Holy Ghost says, I got angels that's surrounding you. That's in Psalms 91. Glory to God. He lets us know that he has angels that's surrounding us. Psalms 91 and 11 says, for he shall give his angels charge over thee. Glory to God. You have angels that's surrounding your house even now. I see in the spirit. I see in the spirit. I see angels are being released to your address right now. And blessings and favor. I ain't talking about stuff. But the favor of God is going to give you the access to places that you were once denied. And the blessing of the Lord is going to make you rich and add no sorrow. Who am I talking to in here that can give God just a little bit of praise because you have home security? Matter of fact, God is so good, he made sure that you have your own personal bodyguards. Glory to God. Only celebrities have bodyguards. Only people of high status have bodyguards. But I want to let you know that you are a celebrity. You are the elect of God. You are a VIP. And God has given you your own home security system that includes your own personal bodyguards. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. 1,000 shall fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand. Who am I talking to in here that can praise God that you don't even have to lift a finger because heaven is fighting for you. Come on, I need somebody to hit those hearts right now on this Facebook Live. I need somebody to begin to declare on this conference call, hallelujah, that heaven is fighting for you. Come on, type in the chat, heaven is fighting for me. Heaven is fighting for me. Heaven is fighting for me. Come on, I need everybody. I need all of you on here to begin to say it until you get it in your spirit. Heaven is fighting for me. Glory to God. Roboshe. Hallelujah. Lord, I give you praise. Heaven is fighting for you. And I want you to be encouraged on tonight. Glory to God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. The Lord gave me a prophetic word. And I want to declare over you that we're moving into a Passover season. And the Lord says by Passover, this thing is going to turn. Hallelujah. Glory to God. As quickly as COVID hit the land, I believe God's going to turn that thing around. I don't know how. I don't know when. But all I know is that he's going to do it and he's going to fix it. I need somebody to give God just a little bit of praise. If you believe that God's going to do it, just like he said he's going to do it. Glory to God. I said by Passover, this thing is going to turn. By Passover, this thing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Well, thank you so much for joining us for our Thursday night Bible study. Our lesson entitled Home Security. Yes, you have home security. God is going to watch over you and he's going to protect you. Be encouraged and not discouraged. Listen, if you were blessed, if you want to be a blessing to this ministry, to Judea's ministry, listen, you can give via Cash App. It's in our title, to Love, Lift, Serve. Love, Lift, Serve. Give whatever gift the Lord would leave you to give. And we, of course, will begin to pray over every seed that you've sown, every love gift. And we're going to believe that the blood is going to be upon your house. What's the blood now? Well, we ain't got no pigeons, no sheep. We know that Jesus' blood was shed. But what does Jesus' blood represent? His blood represents a new covenant, a new contract. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You got a new contract. That's what the blood does. It gives us a new contract that we no longer have to die, but we can live and we can see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I'll come back and I'll explain a little bit later in our next session concerning the importance of pleading the blood. What does it mean to plead the blood? So if you feel led to give, you can give via Cash App to Love, Lift, Serve, or you can go and give via Givelify to Judea Apostolic Church. Or you can, of course, can mail it in to P.O. Box 3471, Florence, South Carolina, 29502. I love you all so much. Don't be discouraged. Don't be fearful. But just know you have home security. If God be for you, who can be against you? I love you all, and thank you so much for joining in. We get ready to close in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to say thank you, Lord God, for this moment to share the word of the Lord with your people of God on tonight. We know, Lord God, the enemy, Lord God, has hit us and has thrown everything at us and has caused many of us to get weary and well-doing and many of us almost fainted. But Lord God, we believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And so, Father, tonight, I pray right now that you would touch every dear heart and that you would go into every home and that you would smear the blood. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God over every believer, over every home right now so the enemy cannot come in. Lord God, help us to put the blood on the doorposts so the enemy will not come nigh our dwelling as you promised to do in Psalms 91 and 10 and you promised in Exodus, the 12th chapter, you said, when I see the blood, I will pass over. So, Lord God, we ask you to pass over us. Pass over us, God. Don't let this plague, oh God, destroy our family. COVID-19, you have no authority. You have no legal right to be upon us. We believe this thing has been orchestrated by man, by the devil, to take the population out. But I declare no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And Lord, we know that in a little while, we're going back into our church homes. But this time we're going back into our church homes and we won't be the same. We're not going to stop streaming. We're not going to stop our conference call. But we're going to do everything that we can to reach the masses with the love of God. I pray that blessings and favor will be upon everyone that is on this call. I pray, God, that you would rescue us, that you'll send divine help. For everyone that's on this line that's struggling, I pray for divine help in the name of Jesus. I even pray for divine release. Glory to God. Everything that's had the people bound and handcuffed, I prophesy that it has to let you go now. Oh my shine. Not tomorrow, not next week, but now. Satan, loose your hold. Release our money. Release our family. Release our peace. Release our joy. You've held us up too long. Release it now. And God, I even pray that you redeem us, oh God. Redeem us, oh God. Put us back in our rightful place. Glory to God. Let us operate and walk in our divine sonship as you have called us to do. And even I pray, Lord God, that you will restore us. Restore us, God. Bring us back to our original design. Restore us. Give it back to us. Thank you, God, for being a God of restoration. It's in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth we pray. Let every heart shout amen. Come on, type amen. Type amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you so much for joining us in this prayer, as well as join us in our Bible study entitled Home Security. God bless you. I love you, and I'm praying for you. If you're still on, let me know where you're coming in from. Let me know what city you're in. I want to say hello to you. How you doing, Darius, my classmate? God bless you. Elder Fitz, God bless you. Sister Erica, thank you so much for coming on. Sister Kendra, thank you for coming on. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I love you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. And for those that are on the conference call, thank you so much for joining in on the conference call. And if you need prayer, I need someone to be my scribe. If you need prayer, you can send your prayer request to prayer@glhymanministries.com. That's prayer@glhymanministries.com. Come on, put that in the chat if you would, my scribe. prayer@glhymanministries.com. Send in your prayer request and we're going to pray over that request. We're praying every morning at 6 o'clock p.m. Yes, join us every morning at 6 o'clock a.m. 6 o'clock a.m. Join us every morning, 6 a.m. The number is 605-475-4810. And the extension code is 194179. Thank you so much. Someone just gave a love gift. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. So once again, send your prayer request to prayer@glhymanministries.com. prayer@glhymanministries.com. And also, don't forget to join us every morning at 6 a.m., 605-479-4810. 118. I almost forgot it, but 605-475-4810. Excuse me. 605-475-4810. And the access code is 191479. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right. It's prayer@glhymanministries, MINISTRIES.com. All right. God bless you. Love you. Listen to the playback and do me a favor. When you listen to the playback, make sure to share it on your page. Somebody just may be blessed by the word of the Lord. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining us. And thank you everyone that is on the conference call. We love you and Godspeed. Thank you for joining us. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.